Big silence.
Is that okay?
They're preparing for difficult questions.
I have to speak about Mauricio. I have to congratulate him for the work he did. And I have to share with you what we already share indoors, which is this club will be always his home. This training ground will be always his training ground. He can come when he wants, when he miss the players, when he miss the people that he work with, the door is always open for him. My club is always the best club in the world.
A team of good boys, a team of nice boys. The only thing that they can win in the end of the season is the Fair Play Cup, which is something that I never won, and I'm not interested in winning that.
I am humble. I am humble enough to try to analyze, which was what I did, to try to analyze my career, not just the last year, but to analyze my career, the evolution, the problems, the solutions. I was humble enough for that. The principle of the analyze was not to blame anyone else.
Do you think no winning the final in the Champions League pay at all in the squad of Mauricio Pochettino?
I don't know, because I never lost a Champions League final.
I have to ask you something on behalf of my father. First, two greetings you from him, but he is now in heaven. And one of the occasion when he was very sick told me, if I ever have opportunity to see you, to ask to picture with you. Because he was always told me to me and raise me like you, head coach any team, like psychological and like winning on losing and things like that, and have massive respect, my father, for you. And if you allow me to picture with you, I will that picture frame it and put in his eternal resting place. So if the match well good for you and your team, would you allow me to do that?
The picture has nothing to do with the result. The picture is done. We do it. If you can meet us before the game, or you can meet us in the hotel, maybe easier. If it is after the game, it's after the game. There is nothing to do with results. So my pleasure to do the picture for you, and my honor to your father, and respect that he feels so strong about me. For you not to lose time, I can say that I had a few strikers that played for me, and they are not bad. I had one guy called Drogba. He played for me 4 seasons. He scored 186 goals, which gives an average of 46 goals per season. I had one guy that is not also bad. He plays for Juventus now. He played for me 3 seasons. He scored 168 goals, which gives an average of 56 goals per season. I had another guy that is not also bad, called Karim Benzema. He played for me 3 seasons. He was not always starting because he was quite young at that time, but he played, he scored for me 78 goals in 3 seasons, which gives a 26 goal average per season. I had another one called Milito. He played 1 season for me. He scored 30 goals. He won 3 titles. And of course, the average is 30. I had another guy that plays for me 1.5 seasons. I say 1.5 because in the other half, he had a big injury. A tall guy called Zlatan. He played for me 1.5 season. He scored 58 goals, which gives a 29 average per season. So, dear Paul, I have lots of respect for you. I think Harry Kane has no problems at all to score goals in my teams.
Baltimore Brito did an interview this week and he discussed you as a player. And he said you were annoying, you moaned a lot, and you were lazy, which sounded quite harsh. I wonder if you had a response to that.
Me as a player. Correct. Absolutely correct.
How would Jose Mourinho, the manager, dealt with Jose Mourinho, the player?
I wouldn't play him. I wouldn't play him. That's so easy. Offer. Take him. Take him for free.
On the day, was it Spurs that were bad or it was Leipzig that were good?
Excuse me? Spurs bad or Leipzig good?
Do you think we were bad?
Well, the result says you lost at home.
Okay. I'm not going to answer you because I don't like your question. I think your question is out of order.
Okay, guys. Thank you very much.
Bye, guys. Great question, mate.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
First question. Are you expecting any player until the end of the market? First answer, no. Let's move. Second question.
Okay.
Second question. Are you happy with your market? Yes, I am.
Okay. So, Paul, you get two less questions now.
Third question. Don't you want a striker?
We'll start with you, Paul. Yeah, I've just sent squad news around, so everyone should have that. Daily's briefing afterwards, embargo till 10:30. Reminder, no social media posting during the press conference. Paul, you can start.
I'm not going to answer. If I answer, I'm going to be in trouble, and I don't want to be.
What did you make of Mesut Ozil saying that he would rather retire than sign for Tottenham?
But who told him that Tottenham is interested in signing him?
Hi, Jose, how are you?
You're good, thank you.
I'm enjoying you on social media. You need to follow me back, though.
Arsene Wenger has a book out. There's no mention of you in it at all, so I was just wondering if you know why.
Because he never beat me. You are not going to do a chapter about 12 or 14 matches and never win it, never win one. So why should he speak about me in his book? A book is a thing to make you happy, to make you proud. So I understand perfectly the situation.
Even before these goals, my son calls him Sonaldo, Sonaldo Nazario.
Jose, 4 years ago when you were at Chelsea, you were asked if you would ever come to Spurs and you said, never, I love the Chelsea fans too much. What's changed?
Yeah, before I was sacked. After three victories in the same week, and if the stats that I was given are correct, 100 goals scored in the season, which for a very defensive team, for a very negative team, is not bad.
Mine and my coaching staff methods are second to nobody in the world.